As Al-Mahdi's army is fighting, as soon as we gain victory against the Romans, the Salibiyun, Crusades, someone calls out and says, go back to your family and your homes quickly, for a Dajjal has appeared. A Dajjal, commonly known as Antichrist in the Bible, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam called him a Dajjal. A Dajjal means the liar, the impersonator, one who lies about his impersonation, lies about who he represents. So he comes and says that he is Prophet Isa alayhi salam when he first comes out. A Dajjal is a man. He's a man, he's a human being. And Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described him to us to detail. And among the descriptions he gave us of him, he said, he is awar. He sees with one eye. Doesn't mean he has one eye in the center like a cyclops. He is one-eyed, meaning he sees with one eye. He describes the other eye he can't see with. He says the other eye looks like a grape that has its liquid sucked out of it. He can't see from it. It's that much detail. And he called him Al-Masih Al-Dajjal. Isa alayhi salam is called Al-Masih. His one is called Al-Masih. Al-Masih means one with the eye, it's wiped. And he said, every prophet has warned his nation against the Dajjal and the coming of the Dajjal and the prerequisites of the Dajjal. We see the prerequisites of the coming of the Dajjal today in our time. It's too much to talk about it, but there's so many lectures and series about this. The effects of the coming of the Dajjal are present now. Preparation of the Dajjal. He represents falsehood. He represents shirk. And Rasul ﷺ describes his hair. He says, Aj'ad. It's coarse hair. Very rough, coarse hair. Black. On his forehead will be the shape within his forehead. Only a believer can tell. Will be the shape of three letters carved in a certain way in his forehead. The letters are kafara, kafar, or kufr, which is disbelief. And he is a humongous man. Very big man. Big, reasonably, proportionally big as a human, yani. Not big as in he's a giant like a dinosaur, he's a big man, meaning he's very full with meat. And this man, a Dajjal, he has signs of his coming. For example, what is known as Israel today, in those days in Jerusalem, it will be filled with dates, palm trees. In those days it wasn't at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Now it's filled with palm trees, full of it. Another sign is that he said, a man from the Arabs will come out as a prophet and his people will expel him from the land. They'll fight him. He is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are a few other signs. And these are the signs of the closeness of the coming of the Dajjal. There are a group of companions who saw a Dajjal in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was chained up on an island. So he will come out freed. And Allah would give him some powers. Rasul ﷺ told us that he has the power to order the clouds to rain wherever he wills, to order the earth to be fertilized wherever he wishes. He will pass by a hill and he'll order its golds and treasures to come out and they'll follow him like an army. He'll rule the world. The first among those who will follow him are said to be the Jews by our scholars. Why? Well, because of the belief system the Christians and Jews have. They will both follow him in the beginning. The Jews do not believe that Isa alayhi salam was a true prophet. They believe he was an imposter. They believe in Moses. They believe Musa was the last of the prophets. And their Torah is telling them about a coming prophet. When Isa alayhi salam came, they said he's an imposter. So they tried to kill him. So now they say he's still an imposter. When Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out, he fit the descriptions of their Torah. But they rejected him because he was among the Arabs. They didn't want to accept him. So they've made up their own laws and saying that we are still waiting for the prophet to come, the true Jesus. And a Dajjal will come out and say, I am Jesus Christ. And they like his ways. They will follow him. And the Christians will follow him because they believe, as their Bible says, that Christ will come back. We also believe Christ will come back, alayhi salam. But our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, be careful, a Dajjal will come then, Isa alayhi salam. The Christians were also told about this in the Jews, but they get it wrong somehow because they've distorted their scriptures. So he will come out and say, I am Christ, Isa alayhi salam. And he'll show them these miracles that he does, right? And that's why they'll believe him. As time passes, he'll start to tell them, I am God. Ana ilahukum. Now, it's easy for the Christians to accept him as a God because they already have Isa alayhi salam, a God. And the Jews will take it. Well, this is what's going to happen. Some of them will reject him as a God. So he will say, what if I bring back your parents to life? They'll say, yeah, we'll believe you're a God, because only God can bring back people from the dead. Rasulullah told us that the jinns will be working for him, the jinns, the other life form, and they can impersonate people. They can appear or disappear. And he says that he will order the jinns to impersonate their parents. So they will, and they'll speak to them, and they'll think that he is actually risen the dead. So they believe he is God, called God. And Rasulullah said, a Dajjal will enter every single portion of this world except for two places, Mecca and Tiba. Mecca, we know where it is. Tiba means Medina. He will not be able to enter Medina or Mecca. Rasulullah advised us to go there if we can. And if we see him, go in the other direction. We can't fight him. But Al-Mahdi and his army will be fighting the army of the Dajjal. Al-Dajjal himself won't go there with a sword and force people to follow him, but rather he will influence you. If you don't follow him, he will leave you alone with poverty, poverty, absolute poverty. And that's why people will be influenced to follow him. Among the Muslims, there will be many who follow him, and among the women, many. But only the strongest will survive that time. Rasulullah ﷺ told us that the Dajjal's trial is among the biggest trials ever. Look at our state now, brothers and sisters. The prerequisites of a Dajjal, what he represents of materialism, is already in the hearts of a lot of Muslims. And this is now, before even a Dajjal has even arrived yet. And already a lot of the Muslims are changing their ways. Alhamdulillah, not all of them. So imagine when he actually comes up in his actual form. It's going to be tremendous. For Rasulullah said, if a Dajjal comes out now and I'm with you, I am responsible to protect you from him. But if I die and he comes out, every person is responsible for themselves. Among the things which the Prophet ﷺ told us to save ourselves from the Dajjal, first of all, is knowledge of the Dajjal, following the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and second and thirdly, he said, recite the first 10 ayat of Surah Al-Kahf, for they will protect you. Allah will give your heart strength if you recite them when he comes. He won't have that power over your mind or over your intellect. Surah Al-Kahf plays a huge role in the coming of the Dajjal. If for those who recite Surah Al-Kahf, you'll see that a lot of its lessons that are in there really speak about our time now, such as المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا. Children and wealth are the decoration of this worldly life, and it will approach, it will attack the hearts of a lot of people. It gives lessons of people who are materialistic and those who are not. Focus a lot on materialism in Surah Al-Kahf. Focus a lot on pride of knowledge. People who think they're so knowledgeable but they know nothing. Such as the story between Musa alayhi salam and Al-Khadr. Or such as the story between the man of the big garden and the man who was righteous and says to him, thank God for this garden. He says, I got it from my own power. God didn't give it to me. And even if I die, I'm going to go to Jannah anyway because God is merciful. How many people speak in this language today? There are many, if you read Surah Al-Kahf and you think about the Dajjal and what it represents, you'll find that subhanAllah, Surah Al-Kahf plays a huge role in letting you understand the current world today in every way. Read it and try to understand it. You'll see that it's talking about today's system.